Welcome to Whiskey.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Löning, Horst Löning. I'm the master taster of Whiskey.com, and today we have a wonderful old Johnny Walker, 21 years old, XR. Here in my cask, well, it's a liter bottle from the travel value. Yes, because everybody who travels would like to have a nice time. Nope, just joking. Price above 100, 120, 150, wherever you're able to get your fingers on that bottle. Johnny Walker has a few bottles which show extreme prices. One is the Johnny Walker Blue Label. I think I had it here already on my cask. And the most expensive Johnny Walker I had was King George V or the Odyssey. I think it was the Odyssey, around 750. Quite expensive. And this XR sounds a little bit as if this one is, well, XO from the cognac. So probably they're looking for different customers, but XR might have been as well some king from the British. Johnny Walker carries the Royal Brand, which is shown on top. And here it says it's the Legacy Blend. He's saying on the back, this exceptional 21-year-old commemorates the knighthood awarded to Alexander Walker for his noble conduct whilst fulfilling his duty to king and country. We are drinking for life and country. Yeah, for king and country. Slongeois. As you take your very first sip of John Walker and Sons XR 21-year-old, give it the time it deserves. Time to enjoy each and every layer of exquisite flavor. Its distinctive character is no coincidence. Only our best will suffice for this blend of precious 21-year-old malt and grain whiskies from rare casks and an obsession for perfection instigated by Sir Alexander Walker himself. He was the one who made Scotch whiskey famous all around the world. He shipped whiskey to all continents, so he was the one bringing out. And if somebody deserves to get the Royal Brand, Alexander Walker has been. Some of the liquid is sourced from the select reserves of the master blender, including extra rare casks from now silent distilleries. John Walker and Sons XR 21-year-old really is extra rare, so savor every drop. So here we go. In 1920, Sir Alexander Walker earned the ultimate recognition, a knighthood of the British Empire. So not only he got the Royal Brand for his whiskey, he also got the knighthood with the sword on your shoulder. Yeah, knighthood. This honor was bestowed upon him for his noble conduct whilst fulfilling his duty to king and country. Yeah, it's the same. Superior blend, sourced as on the back. So every bottle is uniquely numbered. And, well, the card box shows some damage. Therefore, I probably got this bottle on my cask here, and then the seal is broken, so yeah, so it's no longer for sale. There's a hologram showing that the seal is intact so that nobody else can fit some new plastic on top. Very well done. And here's the bottle number, Johnny Walker XR5561BM. So this is it. And plastic cork looks like a gem shimmering. Some gold here and on top the sign. I remember I had that in a different box where there was this cross shown as well. So this might be a later bottle now where they cut down the expensive for the box. Pleasant. Wow, fruity. The first is fruity. And then, after the fruitiness, which is still strong, there's a small layer of smoke on top. Light vanilla, smoky vanilla. And the smokiness is stronger, as I remember from the last tasting I had with this bottle. So this is definitely around 8 to 10 ppm smokiness. And well, below this smokiness, the fruitiness is there, stronger now. Some caramel showing through. And this is quite complex. This is a blended whiskey. Means that they use casks from different distilleries with different flavors, with different distillery characters and different cask maturation. So there has to be a lot of complexity in it. And now some cocoa shining through. Little nuttiness showing up. Pleasant on my tongue, even with this little 40% ABV, strong on my tongue, really. Mouth-watering, voluminous. The aftertaste is middle-long, not too long. There's this hefty bitterness missing, which typically other older whiskies with a lot of oak influence have. So this is really sipping whiskey, really good and rewarding, and the oiliness from the grain is there. If I have to guess how many malt whiskies and or how much malt whiskey is in it and how much grain, I would say, well, the malt whiskey more than 50%, 70% wouldn't be surprising. So somewhere around 70, I would guess. And the grain is really there and shows some oiliness and accompanying spiciness from the oak. Yeah. Oh. This is an artisan work, really showing that you can create a whiskey, not select casks from a warehouse to produce a malt whiskey, but that you're able to create a whiskey. And it's an art to create a premium blended whiskey. Yeah, whenever you pass a travel value and have nothing to drink on your flight, sorry, no. So this one is a definite buy, and the price, I think it's worth it. Yeah, I have to finish that. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. There's more to come, as always. And please feel free to share this video with your friends.